Good morning everyone. I started in the last video. I had explained the concept of the chapter Nelson Mandela Long Walk to Freedom. Now, today in this video, I'm going to explain this chapter line by line, and I hope you will concentrate it very attentively. Okay, let's see. 10th May dawned bright and clear. For the past few days, I had been pleasantly besieged by dignitaries and world leaders who were coming to pay their respect before the inauguration. The lines starts the beginning written by Nelson Mandela. He says that it was the day, a very pleasant and brightful day, and 10th May was the day when the day was also very, very pleasant, and Nelson Mandela, his followers, all the African peoples were extremely happy because this was not an ordinary day. This was an auspicious day in the history of South Africa because Nelson Mandela was surrounded with great dignitaries, great men, great politicals of the world, because it was the day of inauguration in South Africa when Nelson Mandela was going to took oath as a president of South Africa, and those great political leaders who had come to South Africa to join that great program. The inauguration would be the largest gathering ever of international leaders on South African soil, and this day was also very great because on this day there was a great gathering of international leaders on the land of South Africa. So this was very, very auspicious and a great day in the history of South Africa. The ceremonies took place in the lovely sandstone amphitheater found by the Union Buildings in Pretoria. And this inauguration day ceremony was held in the auditorium of Union Buildings. This was a building that was made with very beautiful stones. Stones were also colored, and very nice scriptures were formed on those stones. So this place was definitely a very nice place, and the place name was Union Buildings in Pretoria. For decades, this had been the seat of white supremacy. Nelson Mandela says that for decades, this was the place where the white supremacy seated themselves. And this was the first occasion when the black supremacist, the leader of black community, was going to take oath, was going to have a seat in this building. And now it was the site of a rainbow gathering of different colors and nations for the installation of South Africa's first democratic non-racial deck government. The site in the Union Building was definitely very, very attractive, very wonderful, because this was the first day when lot of leaders from the world had gathered there to see a non-racial democratic government in South Africa. This was the first occasion in the history of South Africa when a democratic non-racial government was going to swan there. So this was obviously a very, very nice moment. On that lovely autumn day, I was accompanied by my daughter Janani. Mr. Nelson Mandela says that on the day of inauguration, I also took place on the stage with my daughter named Janani. On the podium, Mr. De Klerk was first sworn in as second deputy president, and the first term was to take oath as a deputy president for Mr. De Klerk, and he was the first deputy president in the history of South Africa as a non-racial democratic government. Then Thabo Mbeki was sworn in as first deputy president when it was my turn. Students, there is a little blunder. Mr. De Klerk was the second deputy president who took oath there, and Mr. Thabo Mbeki was first deputy president who took oath as first deputy president in the history of South Africa on the day of 10th May. When it was my turn, I pledged to obey and uphold the constitution and to devote myself to the well-being of the republic and its people. Now, it is the turn of Mr. Nelson Mandela, who was going to take oath as the first president of South Africa. And when he came to take oath as a president, he also pledged to obey and to uphold the reputation of the constitution, and he also pledged that he will always follow the rule and regulation of the constitution. He will always devote himself to the well-being of the republic, and he will always do good work in the favor of South Africans' people. To the assembled guests and the watching world, I said. And then, after that, Mr. Nelson Mandela addressed to the guests and the great crowd who was also sitting, standing before him. He said, "Today all of us do, by our presence here, confer glory and hope to newborn liberty." President Mandela addressed the big crowd, saying that today this is a very pleasant day in the history of South Africa, that this new constitution, new democratic government will provide glory to South Africa, and we all hope to newborn liberty for the people of South Africa that will be free of discrimination. Out of the experience of an extraordinary human disaster that lasted too long, Nelson Mandela addressed to the people that after long experience, after long struggle, we are seeing this day in the history of South Africa. There was great human disaster that was held in South Africa. Must be born a society of which all humanity will be proud. And he says that the humanity of South Africa must be proud to see such type of event in the history of South Africa, that we are going to establish a society that will